An AI tool that creates classroom a fun place to be for kids. Today we have a teacher, Soumya, of NPS Benching Campus for a conversation who would share her experience of using AI tool for making her classroom a fun place to be for her students. Teacher Soumya, welcome to the conversation.
Thank you, Mr. Santosh.
Tell us a little bit about your education, the position you hold in the school, and what are your aspirations making the classroom a fun place to be?
My education, I completed my MCA, Masters of Computer Applications. After I took up teaching as my career, then I did my BEd. Actually, I was inspired by one of my principals. She happens to be one of my friend also. She asked me, "Soumya, anyhow, you are taking music classes. I know you're a good teacher teaching music. Why don't you join our school?" I had no idea. I'm good with children, but then teaching that methodology and whatnot, I said, "I don't have experience, and come, we'll train you." Then that's how I got into a preschool where I learned a lot of things, the behavioral pattern of students, children of different ages. That inspired me a lot. There's real fun in teaching. I'm a music teacher too, so I used to enjoy teaching them rhymes, songs, doing actions. Children used to love me a lot. So that's how my teaching career began. I slowly, gradually grew into main school and then I started teaching. I taught English, music, Hindi, computer science, maths and EVS, though my main subjects were math and science.
Wonderful. So we have diversified not in terms of music to teaching in various subjects as well.
Exactly. I learned a lot many things teaching students, actually.
I think it is always good to couple some form of music while you teach any course or subject. I think at least it will break the monotony.
I know. I bring in a lot of musical patterns in teaching math, in teaching science. I used to do that.
So can you use an example? I'd love to hear something.
When I was teaching grade 1, there's a song like Doubles Rap. 1 plus 1 is 2, come on, let's rap. 1 plus 1 is 2, come on, let's rap. 2 plus 2 is 4, touch the floor. You know, I used to inculcate the rhyming, the pattern, so that they can easily remember the doubles of numbers. 2 plus 2 is 4, 3 plus 3 is 6. In between, if children get bored, I used to give them a number pattern. Like, if I say 1, you have to touch your head. If I say 2, you have to do this. If I say 3, you have to shake. Something like that. And then I would just tell them numbers. 1, 3, 1. 3, 2, 1. Like that. So they have to follow. 1, 2, and 3 is shake. So if I say 1, 3, 1, they have to do 1, shake, and then 1. Like that. So I used to inculcate a lot of patterns like that to make the classroom fun.
Wonderful. Let us hear more on technology aspect of usage in the classroom. How was your experience of AI for Educator session with Cutie Pie?
To tell you frankly, I handle the technical aspect of workshops or webinars in the school. Most of the time, I will be busy to check whether everything is going on correctly, whether all teachers or all children have joined. Is there any difficulty starting and ending? In the middle, I would have concentrated like, you know, yeah, okay, this is the webinar all about. When you were taking up the session and then that story, what you told was very nice about the Einstein driver and Einstein getting exchanged. That was nice. And then when it came to AI tool, I was literally waiting. I went back to my childhood days and I also wanted to draw, though I'm bad in drawing. After the session completely, I sat for half an hour or 45 minutes just doing that quick draw and auto draw, and I was showing it to my kids, see how nicely I drew and all. So that we really had fun. And then immediately next day, I just for fun, just for change, I told my students, let's have a surprise. That was class 4. I told them, we'll have a surprise today. I'll not teach you anything. And they were like, you know, yeah. Ma'am, what is a surprise? Ma'am, what is a surprise? I said, everybody have to close your eyes and then I will draw something and you should recognize. And then, yes, ma'am. Ma'am, no, ma'am. You're drawing like this. You're drawing. You have to draw like that, like that. And then many children confused me and many children guided me. So it was fun.
Wonderful. So I see a lot of joy in learning something. And there also, I'm sure a lot of webinar happens which you attend. So how different was it for you as this particular webinar on AI for education session?
every webinar we learn something or the other. But then many webinars, you know, we just hear, we don't have hands-on practical sometimes. And this was really different because we had hands-on. It was a good experience, like we had hands-on and thought we would implement that in some way or the other. If not educational, it can be used as a fun element to the students as well, so that it breaks the monotonous study of online classes.
So I understand that you did use this tool in the classroom. And so how did you go about using this AI tool for kids in the class?
Actually, I was teaching them generations of computers. So that's when, you know, when we were discussing about first generation, second generation, third generation and fifth generation, I had to explain about artificial intelligence. What is it? When I asked some examples, where do you find AI? How is it? Then children started telling, ma'am Siri, ma'am Google Assistant and Alexa. That all those listen to your voice and tell you something. But have you ever seen any AI tool which assists you in drawing, which helps you in drawing? Then no, ma'am. Then I said, today we are going to have a surprise. I will show you which helps you in drawing. I'm not a good artist and I'm going to draw something very beautifully and I'm going to surprise you. And then first I drew something in MS Paint. Had to draw some some flower. And then I closed it, I stopped sharing and I drew a nice flower in the auto draw and then I shared. See, this is what I drew now. Last year I used to draw like this. This year I drew like this. So see how I have improved. Then immediately children started telling, no ma'am, this is not, this computer only has drawn. You didn't draw at all. Then I said yes, this is what is AI, the kind of strokes. I started explaining them how it goes. When I start drawing, it gives me multiple options from which I can select. And then I started explaining. I gave them the link and they also enjoyed. And then, ma'am, I got 6 out of 6. Ma'am, I got 4 out of 6. And when I shared my screen and when I was trying to draw, ma'am, no ma'am, you should draw anvil like this, you should draw snowflakes. There was some saxophone which came up and I couldn't draw at all. They were telling, no ma'am, you draw like this, you make me present or I'll share my screen and tell you how to draw. I said, okay, computer is there to help me. If I'm wrong, I will. Okay, next time I'll come to your house and learn how to draw a saxophone.
Do I understand that you definitely see a lot of benefits of this AI tool for a subject to teach?
Yes, the tools which we had in the seminar can be used with the smaller kids, like grades 1, 2, 3 and 4. They'll be very, very happy to use. For higher classes, I believe that more sophisticated to use for math and science especially. Sophisticated tool if we can get that would help them is what I feel. The main thing I found in auto draw, you know, if I have to draw many things, the screen was very small and when we share, it even becomes small. If we could have a bigger page, have many things shown to the students, then it would have been a little more helpful for higher classes.
I think this is a very interesting feedback. For higher grades, how do you present the same content he has to do? Then I think there should be some amount of an where they could relate to why this tool is important to them. The younger ones might see it as a fun and they might enjoy fun. Trying to color it and save it and show to others.
Yes.
The older kids might want to go a little more deeper.
Yes, yes. This is all, I mean, older kids, they might not enjoy this kind of tools. They need more sophisticated tools wherein in science, if they want to draw digestive system, they cannot make that special arrangement where they can draw only small piece and it gives all the options and that becomes difficult.
Right. Maybe in general overview to understand how it might look like. It may be a good tool. But specifically something you'd be looking maybe a bit challenging.
Yes, yes.
Do you foresee anything for teachers of any other subject would this tool would fit more right?
Especially in math where explaining fractions, explaining circles, different triangles, different types of triangles and all those things can be explained very easily with these tools is what I feel. Science also to some extent, science and biology, physics and biology especially to some extent can be explained. Physics can be done because it doesn't have much complicated drawings.
Right.
But biology, it will be little difficult.
Right. Do you foresee this AI tools like this or some other AI tools could change education in terms of teaching and learning as a landscape?
There has been a lot of change in teaching learning process since few years. Like the teaching learning process was only, we didn't have any audio visual when I started my career as a teacher. But now we have so many applications. Now this AI tool, it enhances imagination, creativity. Oh, if I draw something like this, oh, it will tell you that people can think your drawing can give a different shape, which you might not thought of. When it asked me to draw a bat, I drew a cricket bat, but it was showing me the animal bat. Then children started telling, no, ma'am, not this bat. It is animal bat. So that is why it is not recognizing. The thinking capacity improves a lot, and then you will start thinking out of the box. And it also makes children think out of the box. Okay, if my teacher can do this, why can't I do this? If my teacher can think like this, why can't I think like this? You know, expanding your horizons.
True. So what I understand is tools like this, or many more tools, such tools like this, could transform the classrooms in a big way in the future.
Yes, definitely. Definitely.
And I see also one more interesting aspect, maybe as a teacher, you'll be able to save a lot of time trying to draw it on the board, especially in physical classrooms when you have to go in the future, or
yes,
even depend on the projector and the PPTs and things like that could be reduced much to a large extent. And I also see that every other child will be able to do and engage, get some hands-on, may not be able to become a great at drawing, but at least able to visualize and understand the concepts of what the teacher is trying to teach and probably help the child to learn, because the objective is not to draw, the objective is to learn something.
Hands-on, you know, children, mostly half of the time they scribble and then they start learning slowly, okay. And they'll have a kind of competition like, yes, I also can draw. The children who are not good at drawing also, they think, yes, they get a sense of accomplishment that, you know, yes, even I can draw.
Yeah, that makes maybe a lot of confidence builds in child, and also makes them feel like, no, I also can learn in the classroom, I also can do it. So every child probably goes out of class saying that I learned something today, and maybe that reflection will be seen in the parents too. So I definitely see a lot of an passion in you, what you're doing. Maybe you didn't start as a teacher or didn't think of being a teacher, but definitely I see that you are meant to be a teacher. And I also love to see that you have this curiosity of learning, and you, in the same wise, as you see, I want to see the curiosity in a child and they learn new things. I'm also seeing that you like to have fun in the classroom the way you want to teach students. And it's very interesting to see that teachers do it in classrooms. Thanks, Ms. Soumya C.S. for a wonderful conversation and sharing the experience with us. And I wish that you continue to use this AI tool, like use many more tools in the future, which will make a classroom a fun place to be. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Santosh.